This is a quick tutorial on how to create a flared leg, for example, that is flared on two sides. So I'm going to start with the rectangle tool, and we'll make a table leg. So I'm going to assume that the leg starts off at 2 1/4 square. So I'm drawing a rectangle, or square in this case, 2 1/4 by 2 1/4. And I'm going to push-pull that up, say, 29 inches. So that would be, say, the stock that we're starting with. So next I'm going to go to the Bezier Curves tool. Now, I've got the toolbar open here, which gives me quick access to any of the different curves that the tool makes. You can also access it from Draw Bezier Spline Curves, and here are all the options here. So the one that I typically use is F-Spline. That gives me the most control and a pretty smooth curve. There's lots of options here. I suggest you just try them and see what works best for you. So I'm going to select the F-Spline tool, and I'm going to zoom in here as much as I can. I'm going to click at the bottom. We'll come up here. Now, one problem here, it does want to snap to different locations here, so I'm going to have to zoom in to get a little finer control. So there's one. I'll zoom back out. Click there. And I'll make sure I'm at the corner here. I'm going to orbit a little bit. And escape to get back to the tool. And double click to finish that up. So there's my curve. That looks pretty good, although it's awfully narrow on this side here. So I'm going to come in here. Now, hopefully it shows up in the video. The little blue dots are just kind of showing you, I believe, where things are at. The one you want to grab if you want to move something is the red control point. So I'm hovering over that. I'm just going to click and drag it over a little bit. And that's starting to look better. I think I need to move this one over. There we go. There we go. Okay, that looks pretty good. So I'm going to leave it at that. So I'm going to click outside of there to deselect that. And so we can see we've got a nice flared leg. So I'm going to use the push-pull tool to push-pull that to the back. So that gives us a leg, probably still a little skinny there in the middle, but that's okay. That gives us a leg that is profiled, I'll say, on one side. I want a leg that's profiled on two sides. So I'm going to create a group. I don't need to make a component because this is just temporary. And I'm going to copy it off to the side. And then I'm go back to the Move tool. Remember, with the Move tool, if I hover over one of these red X's, I can rotate. So I'm going to rotate this 90 degrees. So the angle in the dimension window says 0. That's fine. Okay, and now I'm going to move it back on top of the other leg with the inside corners on top of each other. So there's my leg, or I should say two pieces of the leg. So now I'm going to select both of these, right-click, and explode. So now I've got all those pieces and parts and they're all stuck together. So while they're selected, I'm going to right click, Intersect Faces with Selection. So everything that's selected, any faces that are selected that intersect I'll get a line there. That was the line I was looking for right there. So now I just need to delete the surfaces that I don't want. And there I have a leg that's tapered on two sides. I could, of course, now come in and put mortises up here or however I want to work with that. Of course, I would also create that as a component. There we go. So that's how you would use Bezier curves and intersect faces to create a two-sided leg.